Right, another monologue recited by Fred Vernon. With her head tucked underneath her arm. It's a Decca 10-inch 78 RPM shellac record.
In the Tower of London, largest life, the ghost of Anne Boleyn walks, they declare. For Anne Boleyn was once King Henry's wife, until he made the henchman bob her hair. Ah, yes, he did her wrong long years ago, and she comes up at night to tell him so, with her head tucked underneath her arm. She walks the bloody tower with her head tucked underneath her arm at the midnight hour. She comes to haunt King Henry, she means giving him what for. Gadzooks, she's going to tell him off for having spilt her gore. And just in case the headman wants to give her an encore, she has her head tucked underneath her arm. Sometimes gay King Henry gives a spread to all his gals and pals, the ghostly crew. The headsman carves the joint and cuts the bread. Then in walks Anne Boleyn to queer the do. She holds her head up with a wild war whoop, and Henry cries, don't drop it in the soup. With her head tucked underneath her arm, she walks the bloody tower. With her head tucked underneath her arm at the midnight hour. Along the drafty corridors for miles and miles she goes. She often catches cold, poor thing, it's colder when it blows. And it's awfully awkward for the Queen to have to blow her nose with her head tucked underneath her arm. With her head tucked underneath her arm, she walks the bloody tower. With her head tucked underneath her arm at the midnight hour. One night she caught King Henry, was in the canteen bar. Says he, are you Jane Seymour and Boleyn of Catherine Parr? For how the sweet Sanferian do I know you are? With your head tucked underneath your arm.